Today, let us discuss about this software development lifecycle, SDLC, today. So, software development lifecycle, that means, like, this is a procedure, like, what are all the activities are going to involve when starting this project to the end of the project. From the start point to the end point, what are all the steps have been involved. That is nothing but software development life cycle. So initially we have two types of project, implementation and support. Implementation and support. In an implementation project, we have a five different phases. Project preparation phase, blueprint, realization, final preparation, go live and support. Project preparation, blueprint, realization, final preparation, go live and support. In this project preparation phase, we have, before getting a project. This is completely before getting a project. So, as I already told you that, you know, how they are going to initiate a project. So let us just imagine you already given me the project. We are about to start the development. Directly we cannot go and start the coding, testing, all the stuff. So first thing is we need to discuss about the budget. How many resources we require to develop this application and the server's information. We need to discuss about the management and future plans. First thing is completely discussion phase. A project preparation. Will we talking about the project charter? That means we have to take the license from the project development IT company. Maybe Oracle, SAP, PeopleSoft, such kind of. So we need to get the license. And then once you are ready with the license, we require the team to develop that application.
What exactly means by a license, Priya? Like we need to get authorization something?
Authorization, correct. A license means like we have to pay some amount so that for a particular period they are going to give the access. So example, this GoTo meeting is there. It's a product. So if we have to discuss in the meeting, if we have to pay some amount, that means we are getting a license to use this product. In the same way, MS Office also, right, we'll be getting a code, that means after CD means it's just a license only, like a product, we are not, it is not touch and feel, right? So it is just for the installation. Installation means, completely they cannot give you, yes, you can use it forever. So maybe, some areas that may be different, but especially in this development field, they are going to give up 10 years. And after 10 years, you have to renew that license so that you will get. Even like to develop a website also, once you develop the website for this online training company, let us imagine. So they already developed a website and for 1 year or 1.5 years, it will be okay. And again, they have to pay some amount to get it, to extend that. So for that, we have to pay for that particular time only. It's something like online recharge. So we need to get that license. So project charter means we will be discussing about the license and how to get those stuff, the product stuff, how to interact with those guys. And what kind of example, we already discussed about it, SAP. So you are good with SAP, you have to go with SAP. In this SAP also, yes, we need to approach to the SAP labs. Not we, actually the application development company will be having an interaction, so they'll be approaching this SAP labs to get that particular module. So how much time it will take? So how much time, I would like to take the license. If it is 3 years, what is the cost? If it is 5 years, what is the cost? All these things are going to be involved here. It's not that a business analyst is going to involve directly. The top level management will be here. And if you are lucky, enough, maybe if you are going to get that opportunity, that is fantastic. I mean, so usually we won't get that opportunity once you are in the, you know, everything is done and we are about to the landscaping setup and all, then they'll hire the business analyst, the resource and all. So till also they are treating a business analyst like, you know, who can directly interact with the clients and for the documentation purpose only. So we need to get that license, like, you know, and it's already decided. So most of the cases, like project manager and business architects, top level people are going to involve in this phase. And then once you got the license, now a development team required. So you need to form a team. This is the time where we are going to release the jobs on the job portals. Might be like you might have come across with some job portals like, yes, some Deloitte companies looking for a business analyst who have a 5 years of experience. He's looking for a testing engineer who have a 7 years of experience. That means a project is in demand with a 7 years of experienced guy. Like, the client is asking, like, I want only experienced people. I do not want any freshers. So that if you are going to hire the experienced people, yes, my project is going to be done as early as possible. So if you have that mindset, I mean, depending on the client, you will be hiring the team. So how many people you require? You will be interacting with the HR department. You need to send a request to the HR department. I want so-and-so years of experience, so-and-so, skill set I require. So please hire the team. Then there will be a meeting, there will be an interview, and then client interview. Then they are going to get the approval. Now, you form the team. So training, and then testing strategies. This is, again, a different story. As a business analyst, otherwise as an end user, we'll be having some idea about this testing. So, example, we developed a website. So, how we are going to test it? I mean, you have to type the URL, and then once it is done, example, this online training website. So, how you are going to test it? So, whether it is coming fine or not, the first page is good or not. Let me take this online transaction. Banking transaction. How you are going to test it? Enter your ID, enter your password, then transfer some amount, whether it is getting transferred or not. Can you see all the details of yours? Or can you pay the credit card bill or not? So this is as an end user, you are doing all these testing activities so that you can release that project to the public. So this kind of testing strategies, like, you know, what levels of testing we need to perform. So on this also we are going to discuss, but it's like, you know, don't take it as a very serious, like, training and testing team, testing strategies. We will be discussing about it, because why we are discussing about these trainings is sometimes client may ask for the freshers also. If you have a 3 years of experience also, this KT is important, knowledge transfer. So, like, of course, I have, 8 years of experience. I worked with different projects. But every client is different. Every project is different. And the environment will be different. I definitely require a support from that organization. So, that means what actually they were using, which technology they were using previously. I required a KT on that, knowledge transfer on that. And what kind of company is it? So, for that purpose, training is important. So, training and testing strategies. Example, you hired the freshers. Definitely, they require some training directly, like from college to corporate. You need to fill that gap also with this training. Product training, maybe on Oracle, on Java, or .NET, or whatever it may be. You need to train them. Behavioral training. Soft training, language training. So once they hire you as a fresher, they're going to give you all these kind of trainings first. First is client interaction. then soft skills, then English, then later on, like, you know, product training. So this training will be for 6 months at least for the freshers. Then only they're going to give you any project. So all these 6 months again, like, he's not going to pay. Definitely consultancy needs to take care of it. They have to pay the amount from their pocket. So, like, how many years of experience and what kind of trainings, entire things are need to be designed, otherwise we'll be in this. Yes, example, the same example let me take. I have given you a $5,000 to develop a website, and without any training you have hired the 3 people. Definitely you have to give $1,000 per month, but I have given you a $5,000 and within 1 month I'm expecting the project. So 3 people you already hired, but they don't have any experience, they're freshers. Now what do you have to do? Like, you know, you have to give the training and again you have to pay the money. Other way, and again you have to take care of everything. It will be a lot of pressure. Right? So this time, like, what we can do, what actually, like, they are going to hire the freshers and from their pocket they will be paying, but once they got training, this 6 months of experience, whatever it may be, like this training period, yes, they are under the roof. They are here. We already trained them for 6 months. So they might be paying you 10,000, but for client, it's already 6 months of experienced resource. So for 6 months experience resource, client definitely have to pay 20,000. Or, like, you know, maybe 25,000-30,000 up to, so they are going to cover everything. So in this way, like, the calculations will be there. Again, you need to discuss all those things. But from our perspective, as a business analyst perspective, just to interact with the client to get that requirement, how many years of experience do people you want? They might take your suggestion also, what you prefer. So yes, again you have to interact with your your HR team. Is there any resources already on the bench, like who have completed their training? If it is there, like, suggest them. So in that way, you have to help to the company. Yes, suggest them. Yes, 6 months is more than enough. Yes, because you are going to take all this risk. If they are performing well, if they are not performing well, whatever it may be, you are taking the risk. So you can suggest in that way. If they accept, that is fine. Otherwise, if they're really stubborn about their the requirement, yes, I want only 3 years experienced person, I want only 5 years experienced people, then that is again different case. You have to get the results from the outside. So this is how the hiring process will goes, and then after hiring, like, the training will start. So training and testing strategies, all these things are going to be discussed in this project preparation phase. And change management, this is a very, very, very important point, because if something is going to be happen with the management, maybe from the consultancy end or maybe from the client end, you are the person who is actually going to face this risk. Project manager and a business analyst, because you are the face of the project. You will be interacting with the client. Example, Satyam. You know about this Satyam, Mahindra Satyam, right? Satyam Software Development Company. You know about it, right? Satyam, yes. HR. Yes. Yeah. So Satyam completely, like, Mahindra Satyam has to cover it. And Mahindra and Mahindra. And then Sierra Atlantic, Hitachi, like, completely. I would like to take some example here. A friend of mine was working on Satyam. She got selected from campus itself. But that was a very low pay at the time. She is a Java consultant. And when I was working in Dubai, she asked me, like, that crisis, I mean, like, you know, that financial crisis and the Satyam issue was going on that time. And of course, it got solved with Mahindra and Mahindra. But still, she was really unhappy with that job. And she was asking, like, Priya, I mean, like, you know, is there any requirement in Dubai I would like to come? And then I asked, like, that is a very good company. And why you wanted to come here? Like, what is the problem? Just in a discussion. I mean, she was saying, yes, everything is fine. Here, like, you know, she already married. So everything is fine, but I'm looking for the job change. I mean, previously it was so good, but it is Mahindra and Mahindra. Again, like, you know, it's a well-reputed company. Why would like to come out? But she was saying, yes, but still we are treating like, you know, the Satyam employees only. I mean, like, you know, whatever she was saying, like, you know, only 1 year experienced guy from Mahindra company, he used to get a 16,000 equivalent to, like, you know, this lady. So, but he has only 1 year of experience, and already she was in 3 years of experience around, it seems. But the timings was different and everything was different over there, and the impact was there. Like, you know, yes, I have 3 years of experience, still I'm getting the same salary, and he's my junior and still he's getting the same salary. And like, the environment also, he was unable to like, you know, adjust here from like, you know, no, this is the timings were different, but still he's in a client place. But that kind of attitude, yeah, you Satyam people always, you'll work for like 24/7, not a problem, but we have a certain timings. We can work, like, you know, our culture and the way they will treat the employees will be like this. So such kind of things actually eat in the brain. I mean, it culminated that kind of environment. So, I mean, that environment with that mindset, she wasn't able to work over there. Why? I'm giving the training to him and I have to take care of everything. Because he is just a trainee, like, you know, he just completed the training, like, whatever the task I make him, like, after, like, you know, observation, after her approval only, like, she used to send that application to the project manager. So that means there was one barrier again. So that things, like, you know, internally it got affected to the team. Entire team was discussing why, what's happening here. Like, you know, why can't we search for another job? Like, you know, I mean, there are a number of companies actually paying a very good amount of salaries. Why we are here? So with that mindset, we cannot get that work. If you are unable to get the work, you have to face the client. Within the time and budget, completion of the project will be a big task again. It will become a big challenge again. So we cannot anyhow, like, you know, we cannot change anything in this change management. If something is going to be, let us imagine, like, you know, if something has happened to the client or a consultant or whatever it may be, that should not affect to the project. Maybe time wise, maybe budget wise, maybe resource wise, it should not affect. That is completely your decision, that whether you have to hire the people, how many years of experience the people, like, I mean, internal transfers will be, like, allowed or not. So such kind of, you know, sensitive points you people need to discuss. Because that environment should, I mean, that particular thing should not affect in the project. Example, she wanted to resign. Already she 3 years of experience with the same company and a very good, like, you know, relationship. And if she is going out of the company again, like, just imagine how it will be, how it's going to be. So everyone will go out of the company, and then hiring a new team, and then training, and then explaining about this project, complete knowledge transfer. Then later you have to get that work. At least it will take 2 to 3 months. Just, like, you know, for an example, she got resigned and I'm in that place. I'm a Java developer. I'm in that place. So just to understand that project itself, it will take some time for me. And again, I have 3 years of experience, because your I mean, 3 years of experienced person is leaving the job. That means you have to fill that position with the same experience. So within notice period, you need to hire the employee and she need to get the work. She need to learn that work from her, like, you know, a previous employee. So meanwhile, like, you know, this transformation. So within this period, definitely this 3 years of experienced person might be in the same notice period. You may get the resource, you may not get the resource. Because if I wanted to resign to my company, definitely I have to give 1 month notice. And you already given 1 month notice. I will be working here 1 month, you might be working over there 1 month. And after 1 month, I'll be reaching you. Within 2-3 days, they are going to complete this KT. Because, it's okay, like, you know, just complete the KT. It's just for the formality. You completed the KT. Then, what is going to be happen? Entire work, entire burden will be on my heads. And I have to take care of it. To digest that itself, it will take a long. Again, learning the new things. Just imagine, you have to deliver that project, like, you know, on time. How it is going to be affect? If it is like 2-3 resources in a project, completely close. So, in that time, like, you know, this kind of relationship. And that's the reason, like, you know, just imagine the software companies, like, they are celebrating everything, even including Diwali, everything, like, you know, bonus-wise. Like, you have to treat your employee. You have to treat your employee like, you know, because of that employee only you are surviving. So in that way, maybe company may treat or not, it's not happening regularly, but as you are the leader, I mean, you are the face of your project, you have to have this kind of mindset. Then only you can maintain such environment, whatever may happen to the management. And at least, like, you know, starting stage itself, like, you know, if you are going to be clear with these things, that would be really good. So yes, change management if something is going to be happen. But I mean, as for the time and budget, if we wanted to deliver that, like, you know, that decision should be in, at least, like, you know, you have to involve us also in that decision making, like maybe transferring the resources or taking something, like, in a new. Otherwise, if you wanted to, for an example, from the client end, management has been changed. Like, you know, yes, what you are paying, like how much amount you are paying, such kind of things may affect from the from the client end. Now we just spoke about the consultancy. Now just imagine the client, father got retired, now son is on tours, so he wanted to change everything, drastic change. Why you are paying so much of amount? Why can't you give this project to another company? Let them finish this this particular phase, then immediately for the next immediate purchase order, let us go with another company. Such kind of mindset may affect. So even, like, you know, in that times also, like, you know, yes, the decision making, whatever it may be, next thing is whatever it may be, but within time, if you are actually delivering it as per their expectations, that will be good. Just imagine now, millions, trillions of companies, application development companies are there. Everyone can do their work perfectly. Everyone is good in coding and development. Then how you are going to get these projects? You started a hotel, like a food is really good, but if you are not treating your customer as, like, you know, with a good hospitality, definitely they will not come back. So though you are in a software company, that kind of rapport should be there between you and your client, a dignity. So such kind of dignity you have to maintain and everything, like, you know, by looking itself, yes, this company, client satisfaction levels. And of course, like, you know, if they are going to request, you already done with this paper presentation, I'm already done with it, and you're asking, Priya, I do not want this color, please change this color. So yes, of course I have to obey that, like, you know, I should not deny it. No, we have mentioned here like in the BRD it is the same, I am going to deliver the same thing. No, it should, I mean, that, such kind of things, maybe, it's maybe in the document, but this relationship is also important. So, life cycle data management, data. I have the data like, you know, 2005. Now, already 2015, what I will do with that 2005 data? Maybe important, but not immediately. I want the immediate data, my last year data, before last year data, maybe 3 years back data. And after that, like, I don't require it. So, like, you know, such kind of things, like, you know, what kind of data you want immediately? Finance data, HR data. So, these things, my God, these things are important here. All right, so these things need to be calculated, and landscaping and deployment plan. So, landscaping deployment plan, I have another slide. Development server, so we should discuss about three kinds of servers here. Development server, user acceptance server, and production server. Development, user acceptance, and production. Yes, because I worked in SAP, so I just kept the same thing over here. So just ignore about this SAP transaction analysis system. Just look at this development, quality and test, and production system. So there will be a production server, quality and testing, and development. A production server is a real business system. Like a real business system in the sense, like, you know, this you are booking a flight ticket. It's a real business system. The business, the actual business is happening over there. That is a real business system. And go to the supermarket, that is a real business system. ATM transaction, the actual business will happen in that computer is called a production server. So we will, the same Reliance supermarkets, n number of supermarkets, n number of systems are there. So whatever the transaction is happening, like, you know, that is going to reach in that production system. So this is like, you know, the real business systems. That kind of setup will call the production system. So development system, it is again a separate one. And quality and testing, production, quality and testing, and development. Example, in the initial days of ATM, like, you know, when they invented this ATM, there was only one feature where you can withdraw the cash. Apart of that, there was nothing. Now you can see a lot of improvement, lot of, like, you know, things are happening regularly in this ATMs. Like, you can even, like, deposit the money, check, like, you know, online, like, you know, you can request for the checkbook. So there are so many options. How you are getting these options? That means something is happening in the back end. Something is happening in the back end. That means something is happening in the development server. It is not, it doesn't mean that every software engineer is coming to that particular, like, you know, ATM center and doing something. They might be doing somewhere, and the same application is going to be transferred to the production system. That means the real business system. If you can observe, like, you know, a website also previously, the Gmail, how it was, just a HTML page, inbox. Now you can see a lot of changes in this Gmail itself. Like, there were so many things, like, you know, when we used to compose this mail, like, you know, that was a different story. The complete page used to turn into the composing mail. Now it's just a window. And you can see a lot of tabs and something, like, you know, the chatting option, and they were actually adding so many things. There was only Gmail. Now you can see a lot of products from the same Google. See, there are n number of products and even more. Even more. So that means, development is happening somewhere, and once you are done with this, it will come. And you can see, like, I mean, like, you know, this page is under construction. That means they are not actually constructing in our laptop. Our laptop is a production server and something is happening in another server. That is called a development server. So in this development server, you will be getting a 20% space to maintain your documents. You will be getting a 20% space to maintain these documents, and the remaining 80% is going to be occupied by the technical people. The remaining 80% is going to be occupied by the technical people. So this server, like, you know, yes, whatever the requirement you have gathered, they are going to implement it over here. The complete application is going to be implemented over here, and they will be transferring, deploying, you should not call it as transfer, they are going to deploy these application to the production servers so that the real business transactions can happen. Otherwise a common man can use it, otherwise an internal employee can use it. For that purpose, like, you know, we'll be deploying it to the production system. Alright? But before deploying it to the production system, you have to test it. Example, you have developed the application, like, where you can transfer the amount from my account to your account, and you have done that. And transfer, like, your amount has been deducted and I didn't receive the amount even. That means something is, like, you know, the application didn't run smoothly. There was some problem. So you need to consider it. Like, you know, I mean, before going, usually, like, you know, my friend was asking to transfer some amount. Probably once you added the account, transfer 1 rupee, and then if everything goes well, you will be transferring some more amount. That means you're testing it, how it is working and all. So this application is going to be deployed to the quality and testing system. It will be, you will be testing with the real-time data. Once it is everything, once everything is fine, you will be transferring that application to the production system. But previously it was like that, like, you know, development to quality and testing, quality and testing to the production server. But nowadays, even the things has been changed. So directly from the development to the production server, development to the quality and testing, it is fine. Once everything is fine, again you have to come to the development system and then to the production. Why it has happened, I'll tell you. So example, you are a developer and you developed something here, that application, and you just deployed that application to the quality and testing. Alright, so something is bad, like, you know, instead of A plus B is equals to C, you are expecting it. And it didn't come. Immediately you got a thought in your mind, oh, this should be A plus C or A plus D. Then you will get the expected answer. Because development is happening. So you edited it over here. You have done something here, not here. Some addition has done here. Then it is working fine. Now everything is fine. Deployed this application to the production server. All right? Now, for 1 month, you didn't get any problem. From 1 month, you are okay. So, once everything is done, like, you know, again, you got some problem. Now, maybe resource, the same person is available, or you got another opportunity, you are not available over there. So, I'm taking care of it now. So, where I will check, like, you know, definitely I'll be coming to the development server. So why it is happening? So what is the problem? So to check the root cause of the problem, where I will come, I'll definitely come to the development server, not the quality and testing, because it's just tested and done. You're nowhere related to that again. So I'll be coming back and will test, like, A plus B is equals to C. It was the same. And again, when I'm going back, this is not matching. Development and production is not matching. So what I will do, like, you know, I don't know what to do now. I don't know what has happened, what happened in the quality and testing. Again, like, you know, it will be a problem. To avoid it, quality and test, so non-editable things, like, you know, you should not edit anything. You have to get the approval to deploy it to the production system. So for an example, you got a thought, like, yes, it should be A plus D is equals to C. then you have to come back, do that here, and then take that application and test it. If it is working fine, from here you have to deploy to the production. Good? Got it?
Yeah, slight a bit, little confusion in production and quality testing. So, so if you can speak little bit, I mean, about the production and quality, what is the, like, what exactly would be the difference, like, I'm not getting it.
Okay, a production is a real business system. Example, like, as I told you, the supermarkets and the ATMs and all, right? So from the ATM to ATM, you would like to transfer the amount. This is a production system. You are going to the production system and transferred already, right? So like to avoid that problem, like, you know, now it didn't transfer. Something is, like, you know, happening. Like it didn't transfer, and, like, you know, ultimately customer is in loss. Now you spread the same news, like, you know, no, this application is not working. I may not use the application, and my friend is also not going to use that application, because, like, I mean, I lost the trust completely because of that failure. Oh, I mean, like, you know, I used this application and it is not working fine. We are under loss. Now it affects to the business. It is going to spoil this business. So, like, before going to the client itself, if you are going to test yourself, you can test, oh, I got your doubt. You can test even in the development server, right? So, yes, you can even test in the development server, but if it is going to affect, development means thousands of coding.
Okay.
See here itself.
No, I'm getting it.
Yeah. So it may affect, the coding may affect. So whatever the amount of time I have spent over here, it's going to be waste.
Right.
Right? So for this development, I already, like, you know, struggled for 1 year, I mean, maybe 1 month. And because of a small change, it is going to affect everywhere. The links. So this should not happen. So I want a separate thing for the testing. And I should not disturb my customer, and I do not want to disturb myself. I want something new, something separate for a testing. Got it?
Yes, got it.
So this development team, whatever they have developed here, it should not affect in this coding, and it should not affect to the real business. So this application is going to be transferred here and tested. If it is fine, then from the development production. So a kind of, like, you know, before serving to a customer, you are actually tasting it in your hotel. So the same way, the same thing. It should not affect completely to you and to the customer also. So this entire setup is called landscaping. This entire setup is called landscaping.
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 Landscaping. Okay.
Yes. You can see this word here.
Yeah.
L-A-N-D-S-E-A-P.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. So this server setups, like, you know, the internal architecture, networking, all this stuff, again, like, you know, we need to discuss, because some may be, like, you know, a very good client. Imagine such kind of client may go with, I mean, different kind of configuration, a high level configuration. Even, like, if you wanted to take the internet package also, depending on your usage, depending on your capacity, your financial conditions, you might be buying it. So in this landscaping also, like, development, quality, production, like, how many systems and what is the speed, because, like, you are just waiting on the queue. You purchased something and you are waiting on the queue to get the bill. Will you wait? Definitely no. Like, what is the speed? What is the accuracy? And immediately it is failing. I mean, the system, like, you know, every time it is getting the problem. So these things, like, need to be checked before. That means the speed and the servers and everything internal. So all these, like, networking things are called a landscaping setup. So this pre-project, again, it is actually related related to the money. So when it is related to the money, it should discuss before the project. That means project preparation. So we will be discussing about the project charter, we will be discussing about the team, and we will be discussing about the change management. We'll be discussing about like what kind of data you are looking for immediately. We'll be discussing budget and landscaping. This is a complete project preparation phase. Project preparation phase. So now you are ready with the license. You discussed about the team. You discussed about the landscaping. You have the computer, you have a person to work on it, and you got the license. Now immediately, realization. Like, you know, you have to go with this realization, like implementation, work on it. You have all the material. But before working on it, even you need to interact with the client, like what they need. What is your requirement? So you have to go to the client. So that phase is called the blueprint phase. Whatever I have discussed in my first class, like 15% of the project size you have to take to get that requirement from the client. Right? So that 15% space is called this blueprint phase. Blueprint phase. Alright? So that 15% space you have to take to interact with the client. So this is something related to the documentation part. I will be discussing about it when we are discussing on the documentation. So we will be following a business process model documentation method. This is a method where we are actually following to get that requirements, document those requirements. Now I will be coming to you. You are my client. I will be coming to you. I'll ask you what you want. What you want, what kind of requirements you have, like what need to be activated, what is important, all these things are going to be gathered. That is called requirement gathering. Business process model we will use to document. Requirement gathering is going to be happen here, and training plan is going to be executed. You already hired the people. Now this 15% time, that means you will be getting at least a 1.5 month, that means 45 days time. So meanwhile, like why to waste the time? You can give the training to the employees again. Right? So this training plan is going to be executed in this time, and we will be following some standards and guidelines to gather those requirements, like, you know, for the procedure, like when we are going to receive the first amount and like in the second amount, third, like, you know, the like, you know, we are going to set such kind of things, like within 3 months we have to develop up to this extent so that they are going to release some funds like that. So standards and guidelines what need to be followed, and landscaping setup discussion has completed here. They are going to work on it. Training under work, landscaping under work, gathering under work, and after gathering, business process model you will be using to document it. That means complete documentation phase is called blueprint. Whatever you have discussed is completed in the pre-project activity, and once it got completed, you will be interacting with the client to document those requirements, gather the requirement and document the requirement. While you are gathering and documenting the requirement, and reminding resource is going to work, like, you know, the networking architects are going to work on the landscaping setup, and the remaining developers, testing engineers, or whatever it may be, they are, like, you know, your team is going to be training. This training plan is going to be executed in this blueprint. So once it is completed, the training plan is completed, now you will be in the realization. So you will come to the realization. So let us discuss about this realization, final preparation, and go live tomorrow. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Sure, Priya. Thanks a lot for the class. Yeah, bye.
You're welcome, and take care.
Yeah, you too. Bye.
Bye. Thank you.